It is the light of Christ that shines upon us all, that illuminates our way through any darkness. It is the great equalizer, for God's light shines upon all of His creation. Again, we are called to prayer, and the manner in which we pray is to be discussed this day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you, and peace from God, Creator, and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Okay, start waking up. Today's readings would remind us that prayer always begins with an attitude. That it does not matter what we have done, how much we have, or who we are, and what does matter is what is in our hearts. The constant message that God hears the cry of the poor. Whatever the circumstances, humility and concern for justice are utmost. This is either consoling or challenging, depending upon our own attitudes. And like the tax collector, and at every service, it is our ritual to begin. Jesus, you spoke to those who were self-righteous. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
O Christ Jesus, you taught that God hears these prayers. Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
Lord Jesus, you call us to pray with our own hearts filled with humility. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Oh, may the Almighty have mercy. May God always forgive and bring us to life that is everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray today. O God, who alone can probe the depths of each heart, to hear the prayers of the humble, to justify the repentant, we stand here now before you. Grant to us the gift of humility, that we may see our own sins clearly, that we would refrain from judging our neighbors. Oh, we make this prayer in Jesus, your Son, living and reigning with you in unity with the Holy Spirit. You are one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. The Lord is a God of justice, who knows no favorites. Though not unduly partial toward the weak, yet he hears the cry of the oppressed. The Lord is not deaf to the wail of the orphan, nor to the widow, who pours out her complaint. The one who serves God willingly is heard. His petition reaches the heavens. The prayer of the lowly pierces the clouds. It does not rest till it reaches its goal, nor will it withdraw till it reaches the Most High, who responds and judges justly and affirms the right, and the Lord will not delay. The word of the Lord.
A proclamation from the second letter of Saint Timothy to Paul. Beloved, I am already poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. At my first defense, no one appeared in my behalf, but everyone deserted me. May it not be held against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed, and all the Gentiles might hear it. And I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil threat and will bring me safe to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus addressed this parable to those convinced of their own righteousness and despising everyone else. Two people went up to the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee, and the other was a tax collector. And the Pharisee took his position, speaking this prayer to himself, "O God, I thank you. I am not like the rest of humanity, greedy or dishonest or adulterous, or even like the tax collector. I fast twice a week. I pay tithes on all of my income." But the tax collector stood off at a distance and would not even raise his eyes to heaven, beat his breast, and prayed, "O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you," the latter went home justified, not the former. For whoever exalts himself will be humbled. The one who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord. I mentioned we're talking about prayer again. And last week it was about persistence, regularity, praying without ceasing, making our lives a prayer. But as pointed out in the introduction, there's also something about attitude. The example that Jesus chooses is highly political. The Pharisees were the ones that stood against Rome, stood against the conquerors. The tax collector, still Jewish, worked for the Romans, was despised by the people. This is the background. Question, what brings us to our prayer? We're in a world so much about self-image, feeling good about ourselves. We're doing that with the young from the smallest level up. And this afternoon, I'll address some of the issues of the sixth graders. You ever notice a middle school kid, especially if they have a cell phone? It's like, all day long. It's about me. And it's good to have a self-image. And it's good to go over one's life and take an inventory. But attitude and seeing one's relationship with the rest of the world is more important. Our society seems to be like this in the United States. You ever try to get the news? The world news? You gotta search hard to find it. It's all about us, US citizens, as if we are the center of the world, huh? Could care less that Category 5 hurricane went through the Philippines again, leaving so many without a home. Find out what's happening in the rest of the world. We begin to see that it really is a Copernican revolution that we have to be about. That the sun does not revolve around us, but we go around the sun together. God hears the cry of the poor. God hears the cry of the oppressed.
Our prayers have to reflect that. It can't be only about me. That's what brings us together here in humility, huh? It's not only about my needs. It's about the needs of my neighbor, my church member, the people who live in this region. We are citizens of the world. And attitude is most important, and forgiveness. Is it not our ritual, over and over again at the beginning? Lord, have mercy. Thank you. Not at the expense of someone else. Yes, we are to count our blessings. But we are to include the rest of the world. We're always in our prayers of the faithful, is it not true, to pray for the Pope, who probably will never get here in this place. To pray for the needs of the universal church. I was cutting the grass yesterday, I was telling him, and when I was done, I was exhausted, but quite impressed by my neighbors who on Saturdays cannot drive a car and walk to their synagogue. And I'm cutting the grass out there and they're walking to their prayer. And I've learned at this point in time a little bit of Hebrew, Shabbat Shalom. Peaceful Sabbath to you. That's what they say to each other. I'm impressed by the practice of a billion Muslims who five times a day in Salat pray. We have to look beyond the politics, beyond our place in the world. And we are not the center of it. The sixth grader said, "We thought the Pharisee was pretty good. He counted his life, he looked at his deeds. But he did so putting down the other person." That second reading from Timothy is interesting. And Paul is, they had a word, the translation before was, "I've run the race, I fought the good fight, the time of my disillusion is near." And it is nearer for you and me than it was yesterday. We're melting. So what must our prayer be? Our prayer must be constant, yes. Our prayer must be for others, always. I think I've said this, one of the good sisters, you know, explained a long time ago to me that, you know, we all carry a cross. We can't avoid it. But when we're sensitized to the needs of others, and see the crosses that they carry, we are humbled. We are humbled to be in each other's presence. The sun, the light, is Jesus. He is the center, not me, not necessarily you. And we stand together in that prayer. and particularly for those who are even beyond prayer because of their circumstances. We have to include the people who haven't been given the gift of faith. Recently had a discussion with a mother who was concerned about her young adult son, who kind of has put aside the faith that was given him. Happens to a lot of families. We don't stop praying for them. I had to remind her that life at his age is apparently rather long, and that God gives us all enough time. And who knows when? But even in humanitarian efforts, it's not about me. There is no place in our faith for self-justification. You're familiar with these churches that have sprung up, very popular, almost Calvinistic, that we are the elect, that if we have faith, all good things will come to us. Doesn't work that way. Our attitude in prayer must be humble. Each person here can teach me something. And each one of us have more to learn. Amen.
Our response will be, "Hear us, O Lord." For the church, that it may be a model of humility that show us how to pray. O God, we pray.
Hear us, O Lord.
For those in positions of authority, for the prideful and the arrogant, may they come to know their need for God through their experiences of failure, inadequacy, and weakness. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For those who live life weak and poor, for the faithless and those without dreams, for marriages adrift, and for the separated and divorced, for friendless and the unloved. O God, we pray.
Hear us. Yes.
For our children we hold dear, for their safety and well-being during these days, for their innocence and joy, for the new life that they hold for the world. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For all the youth of our parish and all young people, for their energy and enthusiasm and idealism as they dream and seek to create a better world. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For the needy, weak, and poor, for the jobless, and for those suffering due to violence around the world, for the hungry and the shivering, O God, we pray.
Hear us, O Lord.
For the aged and the sick, for the forgotten, for the homebound, and those with dwindling health, and for all the prayers of our prayer network and those found in our special intention book. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For those signed in our book of life, and all those we love and miss, and especially Ben Meinsner and Violet Stein, for whom this Eucharist is offered. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
O God, who hears the cry of the poor, O give compassion to those who would witness your suffering. And show us how to be humble, even when we may be blessed with privilege, for we are all sinners. We pray this in the name of Jesus, model of humble prayer. Amen.
Our presentation song will be found on page 14. Jesus heals on page 14.
Thank you.
Oh, pray, friends, always. Pray humbly with me that what you offer, that it be acceptable by God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
You are the God of majesty. Oh, look with favor on the gifts that they bring, and grant that this expression of service be directed to your glory. We ask this in Christ.
Amen.
Oh, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just to give our thanks. It is fitting to offer our praise. O God of mercy, O faithful God, to send Jesus as Redeemer, moved with compassion for the poor and the powerless, for the sick and for the sinner, to make himself neighbor to us all and to the oppressed, by word and action, proclaiming to the world that you care as a parent cares for their children. With your angels, with the saints, we sing with joy. With love, we journey through this life. Blessed is the Lord Jesus who is here when we gather in love for his disciples and now to open our scripture to break this bread. You are great and merciful, O God, and send down the Holy Spirit to make holy gifts of bread and wine. Let them become body and blood of the risen Jesus. On the eve of his passion and death, at table with those he loved, taking bread, he broke the bread and gave it to them. Take this, all of it, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. At that meal, he took the cup. Again, giving thanks, he handed it on. Take this, all of you. Drink from it now. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the everlasting covenant. It is poured out for you and for many, so that our sin is forgiven. Do this in memory of me. Through suffering and death on a cross to resurrection. Until Jesus the Savior returns, we proclaim his love by our work, and we offer the bread of life and the cup of blessing, that you would look with favor on what your people offer. Through the power of the Spirit of love, may you include us now and forever, believers in whose body and blood we share. God, by sharing in mystery here, enliven us with your Spirit. Conform us to the image of Jesus. May you strengthen the bonds of communion with Francis, our Pope, and Jerome, his Bishop, and with all those who serve and minister to your church throughout the world and particularly here at St. James. Keep this church alive in faith that it relate to the sign of the times, that it accept the challenge of the gospel. May you open our hearts to the needs of all humanity as we walk with them and share in their grief and anguish, their joys and their hopes, that you faithfully bring us along to the good news of salvation to advance together on the way to the kingdom. We'll be mindful of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep. I believe it's Ben and Violet at the service. May you lead them to resurrection. May you gladden them with your face. Welcome us one day to the heavenly home, there to make our permanent dwelling with you and Mary and Joseph and St. James and all saints on whom we intercede. With all of our loved ones, we praise and give glory in Jesus the Son.
Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in unity with the Holy Spirit, all glory, all honor, yours, O God, forever and ever.
Aware of what we pray for, aware that we would forgive others' debts. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen.
O peace I be with you, he said, and peace is my gift of God on all the faith.
A lot of reverb. Give peace and unity to your kingdom, where you are forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Reach out to each other.
Thank you.
Behold, the Lamb of God, the one who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are you, now called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
not finished until we make sure that the people who need communion have it taken to them. So anybody taking communion to the sick, please. God, look kindly on the ministers of communion in their mission to reflect Christ and to make those who cannot be here one with us in this communion. Bless their efforts. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, come on, participate. Thank you, all of you, for doing that. I think maybe we should bring Jesus down to the bottom step sometime. Make it easier for the ministers of communion, too.
Announcements for October 22nd and 23rd. The Knights of Columbus are at the doors for Lifesavers for Life. They are also asking for signatures as well as a $1 donation to assist the Waukesha chapter of Wisconsin Right to Life to put a pro-life ad in the Waukesha Freeman. Support for the Sussex Food Pantry by coming Monday night to St. James for the 33rd annual Chili and Chicken Cook-Off. Doors will open at 6 p.m. See the bulletin for details. In the back, Panera Breads are also available for donation in the gathering area. All donations will also go to the Sussex Food Pantry, so please be generous. Please watch your mail. In the next week or two, all parishioners will be receiving a mailing with two forms: a parish census and a survey from our parish evangelization team. Both of these documents are important, as we need to update our current parish database, and the information gathered in the survey will be helpful in planning for the future of our parish. We are many parts, we are all one body. Everyone's response is important. Thank you.
May the mysteries accomplish within us the salvation that they embody. May we come to possess in truth what we now celebrate under sacramental sign. Grant this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
Oh, you have the Son Jesus in you. May you have the Sun of October on you all day long. Enjoy this. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And blessing on you who have prayed humbly here, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May we go in peace, that we would serve our God and serve each other.
And as we go forth, let us sing, Lead Me, Guide Me, found on page 18.